Good afternoon, YouTubers. This is Grandpa Cabbage coming at you once again from Huntington, New York on St. Patrick's Day. And I'm here today smoking my Boswell with some Peterson Sweet Killarney. A nice aromatic blend. And the reason for the video today, of course, is to celebrate St. Patrick's Day. But I have some other agenda in mind as well. And first off, I'm going to demonstrate today how to make corned beef and cabbage. Simple recipe, really. Boiled dinner, you might call it. New England boiled dinner, I guess is the proper term. But we're going to do that in the kitchen today. I'm going to give you a quick demo on that. And as well, I'm going to submit this to entry in Boontar Jones's St. Patrick's Day video contest, which is Show Us Your Leprechaun. So there's a leprechaun in here somewhere, but it's up to you to find it. So let me proceed. So, with the corned beef and cabbage, you have two choices, really. You have the thick cut or the thin cut. And this one is the thick cut. And I chose this today because it's my particular favorite. I like the fattier version. The thin cut is rather lean. It can be a little dry. This is a little juicier because you've got a little more fat. But I don't mind the fat so much. It adds flavor. So I'm going with the thick cut. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to open it up. I'm going to take the meat out and I'm going to rinse it. So there's your thick cut corned beef. Now, what we're going to do with this guy, we're going to put him into a pot and cover it with water. He's covered up with water. Now, just to use proper technique, I'm going to wash my hands now. Because I don't want to touch my pipe after touching raw meat. So now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a clove of garlic. Some peppercorns and bay leaf. Maybe two. On the bay leaves. Add some peppercorns. A few of those. And now what I will do is let that boil. Come up to a boil, then I'm going to reduce it to a simmer and let it go for 3 hours. After that time, I'm going to take these vegetables, which I previously cut up. We've got carrots, we've got white turnips, cabbage, and red potatoes. I'm going to put my red potatoes and my carrots in the pot. Let that go. This is after the 3 hours up on the meat. Let those cook for about 7 or 8 minutes. Then I'm going to add my cabbage and my white turnips and let it go for another 20 minutes or so, or until all the vegetables are nice and tender. And that should give you a very, very nice corned beef and cabbage to enjoy with your your rye bread. And this just happens to be Levy's rye. Any rye will do, but Levy's is particularly good. And you don't have to be Jewish to enjoy Levy's. So I hope everybody has a great St. Patrick's Day today. Just going to light up my pipe. Got some Irish music on in the back here, in the background, as you can hear. So I hope everybody has a wonderful St. Patrick's Day. Hope you can use the recipe and make yourself a plum with your cabbage tonight. And from Grandpa Cavendish to you all out there, Happy St. Patrick's Day.